Assalamu alaikum, dear students. As you know, statistical inference is the art of drawing conclusions or inferences about the population from the limited information contained in the sample. Two important areas of statistical inference are estimation and testing of hypothesis. In our previous lectures, we go through the estimation, and now this third lecture is related with the testing of hypothesis. The most important area of statistical inference is testing of statistical hypothesis. The objective of statistical hypothesis is to determine if any assumption about some parameter of a population is supported by the information obtained from the sample data. It means the estimates that we calculated with the help of sampling represents our population parameters or not. Because you know the qualities of a good estimates are unbiasedness, efficiency. So for the unbiasedness, our estimate should be equal to the parameters. So we test with the help of statistical hypothesis testing procedure that whether our estimates represents the population parameters or not. If we see the meaning of hypothesis, it means any assumption that we make. But in statistic, hypothesis means the assumption about the population parameter. So if we define the statistical hypothesis technically, it means a statement about a characteristic of one or more population. This statement may or may not be true. Its validity is checked on the basis of information obtained by sampling from the population. Not going in detail that what is the statistical hypothesis, we just follow what are the steps that we should follow in testing, in the statistical testing hypothesis testing procedure. There are five steps. First of all, we have to state the null hypothesis and its alternative hypothesis. In the second step, we have to decide the level of significance. In third step, we have to determine the decision rule, the appropriate test statistic, and the critical region. In fourth step, we gather the given data and compute the value of test statistic. Check the computed value if it falls inside the critical region or in the acceptance region. And fifth step is make the decision and state the conclusions in words. So today we just go through the concepts behind these five steps, and in our next lecture, lecture number 4, we will see it mathematically with the help of examples that how we can test our hypothesis. The two first step in which we have to state the null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. In simple words, null hypothesis is the hypothesis which we state for the possible rejection. Or if I see it technically, it means a statement that will involve specifying an educated guess about the value of the population parameter. So it means the null hypothesis, the hypothesis which is stated for possible rejection, and also it is a statement or a guess about the population parameter. And the hypothesis of no effect and no significance in which the researcher wants to reject. Or if I want to reject it, it will have a no effect on my testing procedure or on my research or on my theory. Alternative hypothesis is the hypothesis other than null hypothesis. The statement to be accepted means that if we reject the null hypothesis, then the other hypothesis which is accepted will be the alternative hypothesis. When we technically, its definition is the statement to be accepted in case we reject the null hypothesis. Or if the null hypothesis that states that the average grade of students is 50, then it means mu is equal to 50. We see the types of alternative hypotheses or the examples of alternative hypotheses. So then there are three possible alternative hypotheses. One be that the population parameter mu is greater than 50, or it may be that the population parameter mu is less than 50, or maybe the population parameter is not equal to 50. So these three possibilities are for the alternative hypothesis. So if the alternative hypothesis is mu is not equal to 50, then it means the null hypothesis will be mu is equal to 50. 50 I have taken just for the example. It may be 10, it may be 5, 0, 1, any value that we estimated from the sample data. So alternative hypothesis have three possibilities. You should also note that the alternative hypothesis of first two types, population parameter mu is greater than 50 or mu is less than 50, are called the one-tailed or directional test. And the third alternative hypothesis is called two-tailed or non-directional test. Decision rule and critical region. In decision rule, a decision rule is a criterion that specifies whether or not the null hypothesis should be rejected in favor of the alternative hypothesis. We have certain rules when we see the it mathematically, or we solve some examples, it will be more clear to you. So just decision rule means the criterion which specifies whether the null hypothesis is accepted or rejected in favor of alternative hypothesis. It means decision is based on the value of test statistic, the value of which is determined from sample measurements. Test statistic means the formula which we will use to find out our decision rules. This test statistic is based on the Z-test, T-test, chi-square test, F-test and many more tests. In your syllabus is only Z-test, T-test, chi-square test and F-test. In the coming lectures we will see what is meant by the Z-test and when we have to apply the Z-test or T-test or chi-square test or F-test. So in our coming lectures we will go through thoroughly about the test statistic. And critical region means the area under sampling distribution that includes unlikely sample outcomes, which is also known as the rejection region, the area when the null hypothesis is rejected. So simply if we see, the critical region means that we compare our calculated test statistic values with the table values. If it is Z test, then we compare it with the Z table values. If it is T test, then we compare it with the T table values and see whether our test is whether our hypothesis is accepted or rejected. So critical region means the values which are used to compare, which are used to make our decisions. If the calculated values are less than the table values, the critical region values, then we reject our hypothesis, our null hypothesis. So what are the acceptance region, critical region, or types of errors? Acceptance region means the region where the null hypothesis is accepted, and critical region or critical value is means the value where our null hypothesis is rejected. There are two types of errors in accepting or rejecting the null hypothesis that we commit. The two types of error are type 1 error, which is denoted by alpha, and type 2 error, which is denoted by beta. Type 1 error, alpha, is occurs when we reject the null hypothesis when it is true, and type 2 error, beta, is we accept the null hypothesis when it is false. So this is the decision rules that we follow to accept or reject the null hypothesis. Rejecting H naught means type 1 error or alpha when it is true, or false when correct, we take it as a correct decision. Or accept H naught means It was a correct decision, but we take it as a false, and it is called type 2 error beta. Alpha is called the level of significance, which is interpreted as the maximum probability that the researcher is willing to commit a type 1 error. The acceptance of the null hypothesis does not mean that it is true, but it is a result of insufficient evidence to reject it. If we reject the null hypothesis, then there and the results becomes non-significant, then there are also we have the p-values that is here to help us to make our test significant. So if we see the definition of p-value, the p-value represents the chance of generating a value as extreme as the observed value of the test statistic, or something more extreme if the null hypothesis were true. You should also note that p-value serves to measure how much evidence we have against the null hypothesis. Smaller the p-value, the more evidence we have. Alternatively, the p-value can also be used to make decision about the population of interest. And if the p-value is less than the level of significance, then the null hypothesis is rejected. Otherwise, the null hypothesis is